the ability to communicate the fact that a patient has life-limiting illness is in and of itself an art that you really never feel like you master. It's challenging, and culture and ethnicity play such an important role into how people interpret what that means and what those words mean as well. In some cultures, you know, the word cancer is not even an entity in and of itself, and so you need to work around it. And for example, in certain cultures, the word tumor is used as opposed to cancer, which has a total different connotation. And then there's the word the word palliative, which in some circles has really been associated with end of life, when really its direct translation is it means to cloak, to comfort. And so we spend a long time, I think, whether it be in the clinic setting or the emergency department or even on the wards, focusing on what these words really mean and resetting the thermostat, so to speak, with patients and families about what these words mean, and trying to derive a positive, optimistic outlook on these words, which are often associated with a negative emotions, and are often seen as taboo terms, and that's challenging, and it's very difficult at times, but a worthwhile exercise with many patients and families, I think.